click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends. In previous video, we have studied the voltage and current equations for DC shunt motor. In this video, we are going to study the characteristics of DC shunt motor. Basically, there are two characteristics, speed versus armature current and torque versus armature current. These characteristics are very important in determining the performance of DC shunt motor. So, let us study the characteristics of DC shunt motor. First, speed armature current characteristic. In case of DC shunt motor, constant voltage V is supplied to field winding as well as armature winding. Hence, the current in the field winding can be written as ISH is equal to V divided by RSH. Equation number 1. Now, if the supply voltage is constant, then current is also constant. Now, our current is proportional to the flux. So, if the current is constant, the flux will also be constant. We know that the flux gets changed due to the armature reaction. But if we neglect the value of armature reaction, then at no load, the flux in DC shunt motor is always constant. Now, we know that the speed can be given by the equation. Speed is directly proportional to EB by phi. Speed is denoted by N. Hence, N is directly proportional to EB by phi. Now, we know what is the formula for EB, that is back EMF, which is given by EB is equal to V minus IA RA, where IA is the armature current, RA is the armature resistance. If we substitute this formula of EB in above equation, we get N is directly proportional to V minus IA RA divided by phi. Now, we have already seen that if we neglect the value of armature reaction, then the flux remains constant. Hence, this equation can again be modified as N is directly proportional to V minus IARA. Now, if we see V is the supply voltage which always remains constant. Hence, we can say that the speed depends upon value of armature current. If the value of armature current goes on increasing, then the speed will go on decreasing. And vice versa, if the armature current goes on decreasing, the speed will go on increasing. Considering this, the characteristic can be drawn as, here we can see the characteristic of speed versus armature current for DC shunt motor. If we see here, as the armature current goes on increasing, the speed is going on decreasing. Hence, the speed depends upon the armature current. But if we consider the no load condition, the value EB minus IARA, from this the IARA is very negligible. So the point which is to be subtracted from V is also very negligible. As V is constant, the speed also remains almost constant. Hence, we can say that DC shunt motor has almost constant speed. Now, let us study the torque versus armature current characteristic of DC shunt motor. We have already derived the equation for torque, which is given by T average is directly proportional to flux into armature current. Now, if we neglect the value of armature reaction, the flux remains almost constant. Hence, for constant value of flux, we can modify this equation as, hence, T average is directly proportional to armature current. If we see here, as the armature current goes on increasing, the torque will also go on increasing. This happens only in case where we are neglecting the effect of armature reaction. Hence, if we consider for no load condition, the armature current goes on increasing, torque will also go on increasing. But as the load goes on increasing, the effect of armature reaction cannot be neglected. Hence, there is certain amount of flux which will impact the value of torque. In this case, as we go on increasing the load, the torque will go on slightly decreasing. Hence, the characteristic can be drawn as, here the figure shows torque versus armature current characteristic of DC shunt motor. If we see here, initially at the low value of armature current, as the current goes on increasing, torque goes on increasing because we have neglected the armature reaction, hence the flux is constant. So our torque is directly proportional to armature current. But at the higher value of current, that is when the load goes on increasing, the effect of flux is seen on the torque and torque goes on slightly decreasing. Here, Tn is the net torque, whereas T average is the gross torque. We can write the formula as Tn is equal to T average minus Tf plus Tw, where Tn is the net torque, T average is the gross torque, Tf is the friction torque, and Tw is the windage torque. If we see, the net torque is slightly less than the average torque. Here, Tn becomes net torque, T average is the gross torque, Tf is the friction torque, and Tw is the windage torque. Hence, if we see, for low value of armature current, that is at the no load condition, we have neglected the value of flux, assumed it as constant. Hence, the characteristic of torque versus armature current is a straight line. But at the higher value of current, that is when the load goes on increasing, the effect of armature reaction is seen on the torque. Hence, the torque slightly goes on decreasing. This is the characteristic of torque versus armature current for DC shunt motor. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel Ikeda. Thank you.